Okay, so now we'll discuss the construction of standard hydrogen electrode. See, it is most important. The standard hydrogen electrode is most important for the point of examination view, because see here, March 2014, July 2014 and July 2015, the very same question is asked for 3 marks. So, so many times it is repeated 3 mark questions. Okay, so here in the examination, just they will give question like explain standard hydrogen electrode. Okay, so if the question is given like that, what we have to mention? See here, first we have to write the construction of standard hydrogen electrode. See here, in standard hydrogen electrode, we'll take a glass electrode. But it is a glass electrode. This glass electrode is equipped with a platinum coil or platinum wire. It is inserted with the platinum wire. This wire is made up of platinum. It is platinum wire. This platinum wire is attached with a platinum coil. Here it is attached with a platinum coil. The platinum coil, a metal piece, platinum metal piece. And this platinum coil is coated with the platinum black. On the surface of this platinum coil, we coat a platinum black. Platinum black means what? Finely divided platinum powder. It is also called as platinum black. That platinum black is pasted over the surface of this platinum coil. Now, chikkadondu platinum anna tagondu adra mele en madbeku, a platinum powder na paste madbeku. That is nothing but platinum black. And here we'll take a solution. The solution, in this solution, the concentration of H plus ion must be 1 molar. We have to take a solution such that the solution must contain the concentration of H plus ion equals to 1 molar. 1 molar concentration. At this condition, we'll blow up or we'll bubble the pure hydrogen gas at 1 bar pressure. To this electrode, we bubble or we insert a pure hydrogen gas at 1 bar pressure. The pressure of this pure hydrogen gas must be 1 bar. At constantly, this hydrogen gas is bubbled through the solution. So these are the bubbles formed by the hydrogen gas. Okay. So this is the construction of standard hydrogen electrodes. Here, once again, I'll repeat. This standard hydrogen electrode consists of a platinum wire attached with platinum coil. This platinum coil is coated with platinum black, and this electrode is dipped in a solution containing 1 molar concentration of H plus ions. 1 molar, for this we will take generally 1 mHcl is taken. 1 mHcl gives 1 m of H plus ions, 1 molar H plus ions. So we will take HCl solution. And to this electrode, will constantly blow the hydrogen gas at 1 bar pressure. 1 bar pressure. See here, the concentration of electrolyte is also unity. The concentration of hydrogen gas is also unity. It is blown in at constant pressure, 1 bar pressure. And here, the concentration of the solution is 1 molar concentration. Okay, now, the cell representation for hydrogen electrode is, so now you can understand this. Platinum and hydrogen gas is blown on in this the electrolyte is H plus ions. The electrolyte contains H plus ions. Now the chemical reaction taking place in this electrode is H plus ion from the solution takes up an electron and gives 1 by 2 H2. H plus plus electron gives 1 by 2 H2. So this is a reduction reaction taking place in the cell. Now, the electrode potential of standard hydrogen electrode is taken as, it is assigned as 0 at all temperatures. Please remember, the electrode potential of standard hydrogen electrode is taken as 0 at all temperatures. Now, the electrode potential of standard electrode is 0. If the standard electrode is 0, with respect to this, the electrode potential of another electrode can be calculated very much easily. Now, the electrode potential of a metal determined with respect to standard hydrogen electrode is called as standard electrode potential. So, I'll repeat. Electrode potential of a metal determined with respect to standard hydrogen electrode is called as standard electrode potential. For example, I want to calculate electrode potential of copper electrode. Now I want to calculate electrode potential of copper electrode. What I have to do? I have to take the standard hydrogen electrode. With that, I have to join the electrode which is to be measured. Which electrode I want to measure now? Copper electrode. So I have to take standard hydrogen electrode as anode. So always, for the sake of simplicity, of the calculation, we'll take the standard hydrogen electrode at anode. To calculate electrode potential of copper, I have to take the standard hydrogen electrode at anode and copper electrode at the cathode. So now we can measure the electrode potential of copper electrode easily. Okay, so I hope all of you understood about this. How to calculate the electrode potential of copper, zinc and so many electrodes. About them we will discuss in the next session. Thank you so much for watching.